私たちの作る理由、これが OMD。
Why we are bringing now an additional model. So it is not a successor of the EM1 Mark II. The new EM1X is an additional model. It's an additional model for people who look for better control, for better holding, and for more agile shooting. If we are talking about the EM1 Mark II, this is for us a camera for portability and agile shooting for fields like documentary, landscape, and macro. While the other one, we see more in areas where also very precise control and very, very quick autofocus is needed. This combined in the end with a very reliable camera that you can good operate. And this is for us wildlife and sport. But as I said before, it's not that we are substituting the EM1 Mark II. We have now two models in the professional lineup. Before explaining you the features of this model, I would like to start with some images. You have seen already our gallery. These are the very first images that had been taken with the EM1 Mix. We have also all the photographers who did these images here, so you can interview them later on. Two we will also have later on stage. But three images I would like to start with. The first one is from Kai, the photographer I just introduced you before. What Kai really likes with the new EM1X is that he has a very accurate focusing and that he is able to adjust the focus. Because as you can see in the background, there was heavy snowstorm when he took this image. And he had to make sure that the camera is focusing on the bird and not on the snow. And this is exactly what he could have realized. And the shot is quite impressive. And as you can see, also with a longer shutter speed of 1/60 of a second. The second image I would like to show you is from Donald Boyd. He is a photographer living in Iceland at the moment. And he took this image in Namibia, and he will also be on stage later on. And what he appreciates with our system is the image stabilization system, that even with longer shutter speeds, also with 1 by 125, you can hold very stable images out of the hand. But more how he did this image, he will explain later on. So I will not take it now. The last image I would like to show you is from Luigi. He's coming from Switzerland. He is also, or his home is a lot this bird photography, and he has quite long telephoto lenses that he's using. And what he appreciates with the system is the quick sequential shooting and also the image stabilization system. And also here, he could, with ISO 900 and a very accurate focusing, and the option that you can group autofocus frames, even a group of 9 above the center, exactly where the eyes of the bird is, you could make a very, very good image. But these are now the first result. Now coming to the camera. The question is, what are the fundamental requirements that a professional needs? And for us, these are three aspects. This is the precise operations, this is severe conditions, and also on-the-spot capturing with good image quality. Let's start with the first one, with the precise operation. What is important is that you have a very rough body, and that is the reason why we also choose a magnesium alloy all over. What is also key for us is that you need to be able to operate your camera blindly, and that is the reason why we implement a vertical grip. As you can see here, the most fundamental settings and shooting options that you can adjust in your camera are exactly the same if you take it horizontally or vertically. So no matter how you grab your camera and take an image, you will always find the right controls. What is also very important when we are talking about precise operation is that all these buttons have a different shape, a different height, that you can also blindly feel what are the right buttons that you have to touch. Also, the concept was reworked because we are now following a one button, one concept operation, because one button, one feature, one concept is in the end very important. If you grab the camera, you would like to do something that you're not confused what you have to set up. Something that we have also new for us in the cameras is in the end the multi-selector, or you also call it joystick. This multi-selector you have even horizontal and vertical, and then you can really keep your eye on the subject while you are moving the autofocus frame with your thumb. So again, blind controls is also something that we had in mind there. Also something new when we are talking about precise operations is a new graphic user interface that makes it very easy for you to adjust your camera. So with a click of a button, you can set up your own menus that you can make it your own individual tool just with a click of a button. And we have here also a C-lock switch that you really can customize before if you would like really to lock only certain operations or the complete vertical grip. You can customize it as you like. Coming to the next point, and this is severe condition. The question is, what do we mean with severe conditions? Therefore, I would like to show you one image that was done also by one of our visionaries. And here, you need a portable system. You need to be able to run around, but you also have to make sure that the camera is dustproof, because otherwise your equipment will be really damaged afterwards. And that is the reason why we said that this camera for us is for extreme condition. It's very important that it's dustproof, high level, and also splash-proof, that you can go out in any environments. Splash-proofed, I mentioned this already. I think all the cameras from Olympus have been praised that they are very good in terms of splash-proof level. And we even also officially cope with the IPX1 standard. And these are very light raindrops on the camera from different sides. But what we are doing internally, and this is this testing, with heavy rain from all sides, and we tested a lot of cameras, and they all passed the test. Because for us, it's very important when the people are outside, when they are shooting, that they really stand this environment. So I have a lot of good reputation from the EM1 Mark II, but now the EM1 X is even going one level higher. And that is the reason why we are talking about absolute confidence when we are talking about the camera. When we are talking about severe conditions, we also have to talk about dust. Dust is also something that is not new for us, because we implemented the first dust reduction system 15 years ago with the first E1. And this was the first dust reduction system ever implemented in the industry. And now, if you take a look at all the competition, everybody has a kind of similar system in place. But we still have the most powerful one with the supersonic wave filter. You can see this in the simulation. The dust, it really catapulted away. It's not a light shaking what the functionality of other brands have. With the EM1X, we even go one level higher. And we have on the surface of the dust reduction filter a special coating that the dust cannot stick on this filter. So this is finally an innovation that we have there. When we are talking about severe conditions, and I mentioned this in the first image already, we are also talking about size. You have to be mobile. You have to be flexible in shooting. You do not want to carry a lot. And this camera with a bigger, better holding with vertical and horizontal grip is perfect for long telephoto lenses. And especially there, you also see the size advantage. Here you have the 300mm lens of Olympus and the equivalent 600mm lens of the competition, and you see how much smaller this is. What does this mean when we are talking about the standard lens? Even the standard lens, we see an advantage. So we have up to 36% smaller and lighter equipment. And this makes it especially also for wildlife and outdoor photography much more easy to take the equipment around. We in believe that this lightweight and small design is really essential. And this is not only the only advantage Olympus has, but this is a quite important one for us. When we are talking about severe conditions, we also have to talk about heat. And for heat, I do not mean the sunshine outside when it's very hot. This is one aspect. But also when you have the camera under very heavy usage. So if you use a lot of continuous shooting mode, when you use a lot of movie, even inside, the camera can get hot. And there, we newly build in a heat dissipation. A heat dissipation helps to control the temperature in the camera. So we have implemented special heat pipes from the circuit board to the outer shell that the camera is still cool inside and that you really can use it under heavy usage. And this is something quite new and something that we have to implement in such a professional model. The next point I would like to mention is this on-spot capturing. On-spot capturing, what is behind this? The first thing to mention is the image stabilization. And also Sugimoto-san mentioned this earlier. This is one of our core competencies. And we even take it to the next level. I think we are leading the industry in terms of image stabilization. And we are coming now to 7.5 EV steps in combination with the 12-100 or the 300mm lens, or 7 EV steps with the body only. The question is, what does it mean? 7 EV steps means you can hold out of your hand 7 times longer the shutter speed. This was also mentioned by Sugimoto-san before. Normally, you say that 1/30th of a second you can hold out of your hand without any image shake. And if we multiply this with the performance of the image stabilization, you can hold up to 4 seconds. Of course, image stabilization plays a special role when we are talking about long telephoto lenses. And in the long telephoto lenses, you even see the effect much more in depth. For us, also, image stabilization is so important because I think a lot of image failure can happen because of handshake. And this we really have to avoid. And all the pros who tested this also said, this is also so great because I can even make sharp images with longer shutter speeds. We say, or in general, we say 5 seconds or 4 seconds you can take out of your hand. Our pros tested this, and they went even up to 15 and 20 seconds. So if you are really professional, you can do it longer, maybe normal average that IMM, then it's 4 seconds. When we are talking about on-the-spot capturing, we also have to talk about the viewfinder. We have a newly viewfinder optics implemented here that we can have a magnification up to 0.83, what is also leading in the industry standard. You can have a really clear and crisp view. And what is very important for us for the viewfinder is that we have the 120 frames per second progressive frame rate. Means this is made for moving subjects. So you can follow your subject and you have a very, very clear and crisp view. This is what is for us key for this viewfinder. But these are a lot of theoretical things. We have cameras here. You can touch and try it later on, and then you can convince yourself, looks of the viewfinder, because this is quite impressive. When we are talking about on-the-spot capturing, of course, we also have to talk about autofocus. And in the 3 images I showed earlier, the photographers also mentioned autofocus is something I really can rely on. And this time, we also have a new technology in. It is the intelligent subject detection autofocus. What is this? This is, in the end, depending on a deep learning technology, so R&D, they realize thousands of different data, they put it in an algorithm, and then put it in the camera. And so far, we can track 3 different subjects. It is motorsports, it is trains, and it is planes. How does it work? Here's one example. So one part of this image, and this is, in this case, the helmet, will be followed by the autofocus, and you can concentrate on the framing. So no need that you check if the autofocus is correct. This is really working. And I mentioned we have these 3 subjects, like motorsports, motorbikes, or even motor cars, planes and trains. And our R&D is further working on more solutions that we will then later on, once it's available, update via firmware update to the camera. So this is not the end. I'm sure some of you asked themselves the question, how can we realize all this? And the reasons why we could implement all the things that I have shown you already and some more technologies I will show you in a minute is the double processor technology. TruePic is always our processor. We are at the TruePic 8 at the moment. And we have 2 on the circuit board. And this is the reason why we can have this heavy performance there. Now I would like to touch upon a thing that is not new. We also had it in the EM1 Mark II, but it's still worth to mention because it's very essential for this camera. And these are the autofocus points. We also have here 124 autofocus face detection RF points, and they are all cross-types. They are all cross-types, and they are going quite until the corner of the image. And especially when you compare this to the competition, this is quite outstanding. Means you're also more flexible in framing because it doesn't matter where your object is in the image. Also, the next thing is nothing brand new, but also very important to mention. And even Luigi, I think, mentioned this because he really likes the sequential shooting. When you're shooting birds, this is very important. And this is the 18 frames per second mechanically all focused, or even the 16 frames per second in the electronic shutter. This is a technology that we also implemented there, and that's also very essential for sports and for wildlife photography. And the last thing, also not new, but still worth to mention, I'm sure all of you have tested this. This is ProCapture. ProCapture is also something important for sports and for wildlife photography, because before you even take the image, you have a buffer of 35 images up to 60 frames per second. And when you push the shutter, then you have even the 35 frames before. So you can take even an image that your human eye cannot grab. And I think a lot of tests has been done outside. That's quite impressive. And of course, we also have it in there. Yeah, the next thing I'm going to present to you, I'm quite proud of, because we had a lot of talks with journalists and also with pros once we introduced the EM5 Mark II. This was a couple of years ago, because we introduced this feature, and this is a tripod high-res shot. And everybody said, hey, great feature, but please make it out of the hand. Yeah, our R&D takes it, but it also takes a while that they could implement. And thanks to this double processor that I showed you before, it's also now possible to have a handheld high-res shot. And this is also one first example from Andreas Gehe, who will also be later on stage and explain you a little bit more about this image. How do we realize this? 16 frames will be taken continuously and will be combined with this advanced image technology processing. What is used there is, in the end, the tiny handshake gaps. So when you handshake, then you move the camera. And this movement will be used, in the end, to produce these different images that are combined to a 50-megapixel image in the end. This is also something that you can try out today. We have the harbor at the other side. Really impressive feature. Coming to one new feature that I personally like a lot, because I really like this shootings with very slow shutter speeds and ND filters. If you go on a hiking, there's no need to take any filters with you, because the filters in the end are somehow implemented in the camera. We can simulate this slow shutter effect. On the left-hand side, you can see the normal waterfall. On the right-hand side, you can see the simulation effect. We can have up to 32 ND, what is the 5 EV steps, and you can already see in the image before how the image is looking like. Means no need to carry any filters. We realize this by overlaying a couple of images, and then you have these effects. And this is a feature I personally like a lot. Coming to the next one, and this is movie. I think also we have a lot of movie makers out there, and I just saw Kauers, who is also here, who are using our camera a lot, and they gave also a lot of feedback. They're saying, you have a great system, but we have some further requirements. And we also implemented something further. Image stabilization system, everybody is saying, normally you have huge rigs and equipment, you do not need it, you have a small system, it's working perfectly. This we even take to the next level, because you have three different modes of image stabilization in movie that you can adjust. Even Kauers produced a film already that we will show from tomorrow on, because tomorrow there's the OPR. And what they mentioned, what is for them very outstanding in the new feature of the EM1X, is the lock function. This is something they have asked for a couple of times and we could not implement, but finally have the lock function in it. The question is, what does it mean, lock function? This is also part of the movie, which will be published in the next days, and you can see the lock, because a lock in the end is a raw format in movie. It has a higher dynamic range, and you have the possibility to adjust your film afterwards. You can give it a more professional and also a more personal touch. And this is something that the movie makers are really appreciating. It's a little bit more advanced feature, but something that is quite impressive. Also something that is new for the interchangeable lens cameras, but not new for Olympus, is the field sensor system. We implement this in our TUF cameras. So now we also have it here in our new ILC camera. So we have GPS, barometer, compass, and also a temperature sensor inside. You can ask, when do you need this? Especially when we are talking about landscape photography, and we have a lot of landscape images here, especially when you're doing image management afterwards. It's much easier to sort your images. You directly know where you took the different shots. So this is also new in there. Last thing, talking about the camera, I would like to talk about, first of all, two high-speed card slots that we have included, and also the double battery. We have a double battery, and if you mount it on a tripod, you can even easily take it out from the side. But we also now have the possibility to charge these via USB. So if you have a USB power bank that is compatible for this power delivery, you can charge the batteries within 2 hours on the fly. So if you're out on location, you run out of battery, you have a high-qualified power bank with you, you can recharge the camera. And we think for on-location, this is also a very important aspect. But this was about the camera. We have now two further things that we would like to introduce today. First of all, it is the flash system. So we introduced a new flash system, and what is new now, it is fully radio controlled. This is new for Olympus, not new in the industry, but now we have a radio controlled flash system that is splash proof, as you can see here, even freeze proof and also dust proofed. So even also again for this harsh environment when you go outside, even your flash system can go with you. The flash has a guide number of 42, radio controlled, I mentioned already. It can work as a commander and as a receiver, but of course a commander and a receiver we also have as separate items available. What is also new is a new software. Most of you might know the Olympus Viewer software, and we even take this to the next level. Name is Olympus Workspace. It's also available free of charge. And it's now possible to really support the workflow from the professional photographers. You even have the possibility to do a split screen. And to be honest, what for me is very important, it's much, much faster. Depending on the functionality, it's up to 10 times faster. So no need to go and drink a coffee until your image is processed. It goes quite quickly now. And we think this is a very, very good add-on for the EM1X, but also for our entire system. What is also important for pros is the next thing, Olympus Capture, you know, because we can, in the end, shoot images directly to the computer, but this was before via the cable. And now we have the possibility to make a wireless transfer and build out a Wi-Fi that we do not have these cables around in the studio. This is also new with this model. So when we are talking about a camera, we always say it's not everything, because to every camera, we also need a lens. And that is the reason why we would like to make a development announcement now. Everybody was asking us for even more lenses for telephoto shooting. And we have some lenses available, 12-200, 40-150, 300 millimeter. But we even need more. And what we are going to present to you today is the 150-400 millimeter 4.0 lens. We have it also available as a mock-up at the back of the room. You can take a look later on. What is here quite crucial is that we have an integrated teleconverter. Means when you multiply the 400 times the teleconverter and then you convert it to 35 millimeter, you can shoot up to 1,000 millimeter in a very, very compact, handy design. So if you go out in the field, this is the camera you should take, and then you're most probably happy. This is a lens that is a development announcement, means we will bring this lens in the next year, so 2020. You can even combine this with some other development announcement, and this is a new converter that we will bring, a teleconverter of 2.0. This is coming this summer already, so means if we are going to the lens before that we just had here. So we said, with the teleconverter included, we are up to 1,000 millimeter. And if we combine it with the teleconverter that that you can add to it, you are at 2,000 millimeter focal length. But this teleconverter you can also use for the 40-150 millimeter lens and for the 300 millimeter lens. Means adding all up this, I think then we have already a quite complete lineup that is coming in the future. But we even would like to go one step ahead, because what we would like to share with you is also our lens roadmap. What you can see in orange are all the lenses that we plan to offer or to bring in the coming years. We will, in the end, have lenses in the pro field, in the prime field, and also in the entry field. And with this, we really hope that we can a little bit have a wider variety for all the different user groups. So you see, we are not at the end there. We have even further plans. More detailed, we cannot give now, but we want to show you the future direction, where it will go with our system. Yeah, in the end, this was it, what I want to tell you, the most important features about the camera. You can have further talks later on. We think that you can be absolutely confident with this camera. I think there are really fundamental improvements in this model when it comes to performance, and we also have quite some new features included. But I can tell you a lot. You know, I'm in charge of product management, and it's my duty to love my product, and I love my products, but other people should tell you what they think about the product. And that's the reason why we have so many professional photographers here, because they really can talk about their work. I think all who made the images are here, two are later on stage. But before we ask them to come on stage, I would like to unveil the product to you. And for this, I kindly ask Mr. Sugimoto to join me on stage again.